there's a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air." I whistled for a cab and when it came near, the license plate said fresh and it had dice in the mirror. If anything, I could say that this cab was rare, but I thought, nah, forget it, yo, home's the Bel Air. I pulled up to the house about 7 or 8 and I yelled to the cabbie, "Yo, home, smell you later." Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there to sit on my throne as the Prince of Bel Air.
Good morning, Phoenix High School. I'm Danon Johnson, and it's already February. Where did the time go?
And I'm Karina Carrera, and welcome back to another episode of PHTV. This is Blue Team's first show for second semester.
Seniors, the senior picture deadline is coming up very soon. To be exact, it is this Friday. Please be sure to turn in your pictures to Mr. Rhodes before February 9th. There'll be a $20 late fee for all pictures submitted after February 9th.
Un recordatorio para los seniors, tienen que entregar sus fotos para el anuario antes del 9 de febrero. Para ser exactos, es este viernes. Fotos entregadas después del 9 de febrero tendrán que pagar $20.
Email a digital copy of your picture to Phoenix HS Yearbook at phoenixk12.or.us or drop it off in the yellow envelope in front of Mr. Rhodes' room with your name on it. If you cannot afford or are having trouble getting your senior pictures taken, please see Mr. Rhodes in room N206A.
Si no puedes pagar o tienes problemas para obtener fotos para el anuario, por favor de consultar con el señor Rhodes en la habitación N206A. Puedes mandar sus fotos por email a phoenixhsyearbook@phoenix.k12.or.us o puedes dejar sus fotos con su nombre en el sobre amarillo en la puerta del señor Rhodes.
Also, seniors, start thinking of a senior quote. Turn in your senior quotes before February 26th and be sure to return your senior quotes to Mr. Rhodes in room 10206A. Make sure they are school appropriate and only 200 characters long.
Seniors, el 26 de febrero es el último día de entregar sus citas para el anuario. Entonces pónganse a pensar en sus citas desde ahora y por favor de entregarlos antes del 26 de febrero.
Senior baby ads can be purchased at www.jostins.com/yearbookads until February 16th. For more information on yearbook and senior deadlines, please see Mr. Rhodes in room N206A. Speaking about senior baby ads, senior baby pictures are due April 6th. Our very own Cade Beer and I made a segment to remind all seniors. Let's roll it.
Man, senior year is so easy. I got nothing to worry about.
Hey, yo, what up, bro?
Hey, what's up, dude?
Nothing much. How you been?
Pretty good. Pretty
get the good. Senior baby pictures in?
Ooh, I haven't. When are they due again?
April 6th.
Wait, what'd you say?
April 6th, dog.
It's laying on the wake, staring at the
April 6th.
No!
Senior baby pictures are due Friday, April 6th. Senior baby ads can be purchased at www.jostins.com/yearbookads until February 16th. Also, senior coats will be due before February 26th.
This announcement is for juniors and seniors. The prom theme for this year is Casablanca, an evening in Morocco, 1940s.
It'll be held on Saturday, April 14th at the Ashland Springs Hotel in downtown Ashland. If you'd like to go but are concerned you can't afford the $20 tickets, go see Miss Robin in N412. This week about possible ways you can earn a ticket. There are limited ways to do so, and it's on first-come, first-served basis, so go see her ASAP.
Speaking of seniors, Justice William is asking for your help with her Miss Rogue Valley campaign. Buy two, donate one toiletry drive.
The concept of the drive is when you go shopping, rather than buying one shampoo, buy two and donate one to the Maslow Project. Bins will be located at the front office labeled Maslow's Maslow Donation, where they can be dropped off or brought to Justice Williams directly.
New items like combs, shampoo, feminine products, lotion, etc. The drive will go until the end of February. All your donations will be gratefully appreciated. Bailey Olson made a segment. Let's play it.
Meet Justice Williams. What is the purpose of the Miss Rogue Valley pageant?
So the purpose of the Miss Rogue Valley Scholarship Program is that it is a pageant competition that allows young women in the Rogue Valley to compete for scholarship money, and it builds your skills and confidence and interview, and it's overall just a really fun experience that promotes a kind of sisterhood friendship, and it's also the first step to Miss America and Miss Universe.
What is the Maslow Project?
So Maslow Project is an organization that helps homeless youth and families in the Rogue Valley, and they provide anything from things I might need for school to just helping with basic adult skills like setting up appointments, and they have all kinds of resources that are very helpful.
Is the Maslow Project and Miss Rogue Valley helping you get ready for your future career?
Maslow Project and Miss Rogue Valley are both helping me get ready for my future career. While neither of them necessarily have to do anything with the medical field, Miss Rogue Valley, like I said before, it does help you build a lot of confidence, which is great for basically anything you want to do. And it also does help with interview skills, so I know that when I interview for scholarships and for jobs, I do very, very well. I've actually used those interview skills before when I applied to the PEO scholarship and was chosen out of our school to to participate in that scholarship. And Maslow Project is obviously helping me get to where I need to go career-wise just by getting me through high school. They've allowed me to try things like cross-country, which was not my thing, but they helped me get shoes and shorts and stuff like that so I could practice. And they also pay a lot of the school fees, so if I want to take an art class or any other class that requires a school fee, they pay for those things, so I'm able to take the classes I need to take.
Is there any advice that you would like to give to others to help the community?
My advice to the community for helping the community in general is setting up volunteering events and setting up toiletry drives or fundraising just for local organizations like this, because you don't really know who in our school might be working with Maslow Project. I mean, it's different helping someone who's so local to you. And when you guys donate, there was a lot of donations last year. When you guys donate that stuff, you are not only helping people just in the Valley in general, but you're helping kids that are in your school right now that you may not know you're helping. And I mean, honestly, if you are one of those kids who needs help, or you know someone who needs help, don't be afraid to get that help, because I am not embarrassed or ashamed at all that sometimes I need help paying for a class, or sometimes I need help, getting shampoo. Those are basic needs, and it's nothing to be ashamed of, because honestly, especially when you're a youth and homeless or in transition or struggling financially, 9 times out of 10, that's not something that you could have helped, and it's not your parents' fault either necessarily, or your guardian's fault, but it's the situation that you're in, and rather than be bummed out about it, get out there and do something about it, It's your life, and take it into your own hands, and it'll work out a lot better for you.
Make sure to donate toiletries to help Justice and the Maslow Project.
Don't forget that La Clinica Medical Services will be here this Thursday and every Thursday for the rest of the school year. Sign up with Mr. Kuhl if you would like to see the La Clinica Medical Bus.
No olvide que los servicios médicos de la clínica estarán aquí este jueves y todos los jueves durante el resto del año escolar. Regístrese con el señor Akil si desea ver el autobús médico de la clínica.
A few leadership announcements now. There will be a Valentine's Day candy grams being sold at break and lunch starting February 5th through February 13th. The candy grams will be delivered on Valentine's Day. The following candy grams are available to buy.
Chocolate hearts are being sold for 75 cents for 6 and 12 for $1.50. Hershey Kisses will be sold for 75 cents for a bag of 6 and 12 for $1.
Chocolate roses will be sold for 75 cents each, and sweetheart candies will be sold for 50 cents a box. Check out the candy grams and the commons starting today through February 13th.
Speaking of Valentine's Day, the DECA Club is doing a candy raffle in honor of Valentine's Day. It costs 25 cents per guest to guess how much candy is in the jar. Whoever guesses the closest number to the amount of candy in the jar wins the whole jar.
The DECA Club will be in the commons from now until February 8th for you to try and guess. The winner will be announced on Thursday, February 8th. Good luck to all those guessing the DECA Valentine's Day candy raffle.
In additional DECA news, at the DECA competition at OIT last week, Phoenix DECA had some outstanding results.
In travel and tourism team decision making, Kevin Bodermans and Jack Stricker were second overall, followed in third overall by Sophia Tringolo and Austin Voss. Also in the same event, Caitlin Hansen and Aaron Mendez were third in testing.
Emma Trix won her role play in hotel and lodging while taking third overall. In restaurant marketing, Mason Stella was second in his test.
Also, Mr. Cavallo and DECA, along with Kevin Boderman, would want to thank all who showed up to an awesome lit winter formal. If you have any feedback to make it better in the future, talk to Mr. Cavallo or Kevin.
Listen up, all grade levels. This is for all students. Would you like to be a part of a dance-off in the spring assembly in April? Students in each grade level will perform against other grade levels and a teacher troops for the best Milli Vanilli style dance-off. Each grade level will need their own organizer to plan practices and prepare.
If you would like to dance or help organize practices for your grade level, sign up in Mrs. Robbins' room in 412 or at the table across from the office. Sign up by Tuesday, February 13th. It will only happen if there is enough interest.
Do you need community service hours? Do you love gardening? Do you want to learn how to garden? If you answered yes to any of these questions, then come back. Check out Garden Club. Garden Club will be meeting after school every Thursday from 3:30 to 4:30.
The theater department would like to notify all students that auditions for Thoroughly Modern Millie, the spring musical, will be held on Tuesday, February 6th and Wednesday, February 7th after school. Students are encouraged to show up and try out for what is sure to be amazing and wonderful spring musical experience.
In Phoenix High School Equestrian News, the Phoenix Drill Team placed third overall in this past week's weekend's competition. Riley Hayes and Ashley Day placed third in working pairs.
Individual results include Riley Hayes placing third in saddle seat, fourth in dressage, and fourth in English equestrian. Great job, Phoenix Equestrian Riders.
Okay, let's transition to sports news. We have an announcement from the girls' golf coach. Girls' golf will be right around the corner. Let's get ready for a great year of fun and laughter. We will have another meeting this week before the season begins on February 26th.
The schedule is almost complete, and we want to make sure that you have your insurance and physical in before season begins. If you have any questions about girls' golf, be sure to get a hold of Coach Engel in the office or in room N307A.
Girls softball will be starting open gym every Sunday from 11 to 1 p.m. This is a great way to get in softball shape for anyone interested in trying out for the team this year. For more information, get in contact with Coach Steph in room N302.
In wrestling news, the team held a Skyline Conference dual meet against North Valley and Mazama. The Pirates battled hard, losing a tough match to Mazama, but defeated North Valley to finish second in the Skyline standings. Great job, wrestling team. The team will be traveling to Hidden Valley this Friday for a two-day regional meet. Good luck, wrestling team.
The boys' basketball team played last Thursday against Hidden Valley. The team fought hard, coming in with a win score of 50-43 against Hidden Valley. Great job, boys. This week, the boys will be traveling on Tuesday to North Valley and Henley on Friday, so make sure to wish them luck.
In girls' basketball, the team played Hidden Valley on Thursday, coming up short in a hard-fought game against one of the Skyline Conference's best.
The girls will also be traveling away this week to North Valley on Tuesday and Friday to Henley. Good luck, team. Also in basketball news, our Phoenix Unified basketball team played their first game last week, beating Crater in an exciting 21-20 final.
Wyatt Thorpe hit a free throw with no time on the clock to seal the victory. Great job, Phoenix Unified Basketball.
Our swim team took the last week off to rest and prepare for districts. This week on Friday and Saturday, our swim team will travel to North Bend for the districts meet. Good luck at districts this weekend, swim team. All right, that wraps up our show for today. The last thing we need to do now is trivia.
Last week's trivia question was, when was the last day for schedule changes?
And the winner is...
Max Mortensen. You said February 3rd.
Congratulations. See Mr. Rhodes after advisory to get your Dutch Rose gift card.
This week's trivia question is, when are senior quotes due? Make sure to write your answer on a piece of paper along with your name and your advisor's name. Place it in the envelope on Mr. Rhodes' door. Maybe next week you'll win your Dutch Bros gift card.
La pregunta de trivia esta semana es, ¿cuándo es el último día de entregar sus citas de seniors? Asegúrate de escribir tu respuesta en un pedazo de papel junto con tu nombre y el nombre de tu consejero. Y ponlo dentro del sobre que está en la puerta del señor Rhodes. Tal vez la próxima semana tú puedes ganarte una tarjeta de regalo de Dutch Bros.
Be sure to stick around for the Pledge of Allegiance following our show, and as always, check out our online platform, phtvnews.com. Have a great week, Phoenix High School. This has been your school,
your people, and your news.
When you feel-